Light and shadow. This is surprisingly better than I thought it was going to be. I don't know why. There's a kitty, right? Right there. Licking himself. There, Draco. Sarah was put into a mental hospital, but this mental hospital is a type of out-of-the-way hospital that families use when they want to have another family member disappear. So they may not be have a real mental problem, it's just that they are put there to get them out of the way. And the hospital is paid big money. I believe they call it a manor in here. So Sarah meets another lady in there, and they escape, and they get false identifications, and they start their lives over again as Zoe and Arcadia. So Zoe opens up a business, interior decorating business. Zoe has a gift. She's able to walk into rooms and feel emotions. So if there was people in a place that were very happy and she walks in, she may feel very comfortable in the room and it feels very nice. If there had been violence in that room, somebody was beaten, killed, she can walk in and she feels, she doesn't hear voices, she just feels. She feels the emotions left over in the walls of the room, the terror, the upset, the fear. And of course people think that she's crazy when she talks about this. So she is at a client's home and she feels the rage and anger in a bedroom, and she knows something terrible has happened there. And she's pretty sure that her client has murdered his wife, so she hires a private investigator, which now comes in Ethan. Ethan's brother was killed. Ethan's brother was married to Bonnie, and they have two boys. So Ethan helps out his sister-in-law with raising of the two boys now. And he didn't give up until he tracked down his brother's murder. So he gets involved with Zoe and figuring out if this is a murder that happened in the house and if her client is actually a murderer, which gets a little involved, a little in depth, and a little dangerous. And then she has to deal with the people from the manor that she escaped from. So we have a couple internet hackers. There's the man or the internet person who got her fake ID, because of course they use, the one is called, I believe, Gopher Boy. I can't remember right now what the other internet hacker calls himself, but Ethan also has a friend who owns a secondhand bookstore, and he's interesting. The bookstore sounds really interesting. You start bringing in a lot of characters from the hospital or manor that she was in, and the corruption going on there and the embezzlement, and then one of the employees come after Zoe, and that gets really quite involved and quite in depth. There ends up being a couple more murders, and Ethan and Zoe get into quite a bit. Now, Zoe's husband was murdered, and Zoe believes her husband's brother murdered him because of the business they were in together, and then that her husband's brother put her in the hospital to get her out of the way so she couldn't have anything to do with the money from the business. Now that his brother's out of the way, her husband, and get her out of the way, then the business is his and the money from the business. But it kind of gets a little twisted there. There's a little twist to that story that it's not exactly that way. But I'm not going to give that away. So it does get in depth. The guy that comes after her, and then they have to go to the manor, and they have to confront the people there, and they kind of get involved with a couple people there, and then at the manor, and it gets real interesting. And Ethan gets a pink house. And the house is extremely pink. Everything in the house is pink. And there's a whole storyline behind why the house is pink and how he ends up with this very pink home. And there's also a storyline surrounding the pink home, too. So there's actually, surprisingly, a fair bit and a lot of characters and a lot of events and suspense and mystery that goes on in this book. So it's if you're interested in that, it's worth a read.